Welcome to our channel Right Click Education. In this video, we will learn how to implement Angular Material Expansion Panel in our Angular application. So, without any delay, let's get started. Open your Chrome, type Angular Material, click on the first link, that is material.angular.io, which is the official website for Angular Material. Click on it. Click on this component on the top navigation bar. You can see in the left side panel all the elements are present. All the Angular Material elements are here. So today we will learn how to implement expansion panel. So let me click on expansion panel and I will quickly show you how it looks like in Angular Material. So if you see here, right, this is an example of Angular Material expansion panel. So if you click on this, this panel is getting expanded, right? So it is basically used whenever you have lot of sections in your page and you want to expand those section, you want to save some space. So by default you will show this expansion panel, and if user want to see more data, you can click on this and see the more detailed data, right? So for that purpose this expansion panel is used. So let's implement it. So let me open my VS Code. So in order to implement it, let's first click on API and we will take this import which is needed for implementing Material Expansion Panel. So copy it, open your VS Code, go to app.model.ts, scroll down, paste it here, copy this mat expansion module, inside the import section of ng module, paste it. So now we have imported the math expansion module. Now we can implement it in writing some HTML. So let's see. Go to overview, click on this view code. Okay, so what you can see here, you can see we have this math accordion. Okay, inside this math accordion we have this mat expansion panel. Okay, so what I will do, I will quickly copy this piece of code in order to save time and paste it in the HTML file, that is app.component.html. Paste it here. Okay, so now let's also close this mat accordion, right? Now you can see we have this mat accordion, inside this we have this mat expansion panel. Okay, what we will do, we will remove this part. Okay, now you can see in the mat expansion panel we have this mat panel header. Okay, so it will basically give us the header. Inside that we have this mat panel title, mat panel description, right? So in order to see how it looks on UI, let's compile our code, type ng serve, enter. It will take couple of seconds. to compile the code. So it's getting compiled. Let's go on Chrome and open localhost 4200 to see how it looks like on a screen. Okay, so let's do that. Click on localhost 4200. You can see here, right? This is the expansion title. This is a summary of content. And if I click on it, since we don't have given any content to our expansion panel, so nothing is here, right? So let's provide some content also. In order to do that, so let's go to our HTML code. Okay, and so we will suppose give some div here. Okay, and give something, suppose right click education, right? Let's see what changes it makes on our UI. So let's click on it. Now you can see, right, in the content section, this is here, right? So what I will do, I will take some that form field, that form field, that label, give some name, post description. Okay, give some input, so now let's see how it looks like. Okay, and what we will do, we will just copy some of it. Okay, now let's see. So you can see, right, this is by default, this is the title of this expansion panel. This is subtitle or little bit description about the header. Click here, you can see, right, this form field is here. So in this way you can implement the basic expansion panel. Okay, you can give some elements here which will have all the, you know, data part. Now let's see this disabling the panel. Okay, so expansion panel can be disabled using disabled attribute. A disabled expansion panel can't be toggled by the user but can still be manipulated programmatically. Okay, one more thing, expansion panel includes a toggle icon at the end of header to indicate the expansion state. This icon can be hidden via hide toggle property. Okay, so let's just quickly implement it. This is expansion panel. I will do hide toggle. Let's say it's true. Let's see what happens. If you see, right, there is no icon here to click for us, right? It is working but it's hidden, right? Let's make it false. Now if you see, right, this icon is here. So this is one use case. You can use hide toggle to show those button. Okay, another thing is using this disabled. Okay, so this by using this disabled, let's see how it works. Let's go here. Disabled equals to false. Let's see. So you can expand it. Okay. Let's put disabled equals to true. Now you cannot expand it, right? So if you want to show something like this, something like expansion panel or this information here, but you don't want to get it expanded, right? So you can use in disabled property. Okay, so these are the different implementation of expansion panel. Okay, and also you can have multiple expansion panels, okay, inside your accordion. For that, you can see here, multiple expansion panel can be combined into an accordion. The multi-true input allows the expansion state to set independently of each other. Okay, so for the mat accordion, you can basically use this property multi-true, and you can use more than one expansion. So let's try this also. Let's remove this extra coding that we have done to show some forms to. Okay, so let's copy this expansion panel. Okay, paste it. Fine, remove this extra property that we have given. Okay, all these things. Now let's go to our UI and let's see. You can see this is implemented, right? So we have two expansion panel. Now let's play with it. Multi equals to true. Okay, now let's go here. What it means is multi expansion panel is allowed. Okay, now I will make it as false. Now let's see what happens. So if you see here, when multi equals to false, just one expansion panel can be expanded at a given time. Okay, so what is happening? If you see, I have expanded this, and if I am trying to expand this one, then the previous one is get closed. Okay, so if there is a scenario you want to open all the expansion panel, you can put multi as true. Okay, and if you want to open one expansion panel at a time, okay, then you can make this multi property as false. That's it. So in this way, we have seen in how many different ways and different implementations of this expansion panel. In this way, you can implement Angular Material expansion panel. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. And if you haven't subscribed our channel, please do subscribe the channel to get more updates, and also press on the bell icon. Thanks and have a nice day.